As a kid, Ricky became boxing mad. Ricky joined the local amateur boxing gym where the owner, Ted Pete, immediately spotted a boxing protege in the making.
I said to him, put these gloves on, son, and go on that bag. So we heard thud, thud, thud. I said, what's your name? So he said, Richard Hatton. I said, listen, son, I've been in the game a long time. You've boxed before. And there started the career of Richard Hatton.
Ricky began a hugely successful amateur boxing career that led to his later professional triumphs. And mum and dad take every opportunity to show off Ricky's war chest.
These are the original belts that he won.
So they're on our coffee table in a box. In a box.
But the unique qualities that Ricky inherited from his parents are quite different. Mum Carol provides the fight.
She's a psychopath, my mum. I mean, you certainly won't mess with her.
I think it's all down to your left hook.
She's always whacking me. It's like, come on, superstar, get the pots done. And you said no or you didn't want to do it, you get a crack.
There's one thing about my wife, she calls a spade a spade.
Mum's got a little bit of a feisty side to her, a little bit of an aggressive side.
And Dad Ray provides the sensitivity.
Your dad hasn't got a fight in him, he's like 4 foot nothing.
I always remember my dad turning around and said, you've got to get married, son, because you can't be happy all your life.
You're only little, but you're strong.
Why do you keep emphasising that I'm only little?
Because you are!
My dad was the brains and my mum, she wouldn't stand no messing.
Ricky didn't go straight into professional boxing. After leaving the pub trade, another career beckoned, as Dad tried to entice him into the new family business.
This is one of the big shops that we have in Gorton, Manchester. These were like the shops that Ricky first started working for me.
You know.
A job he wasn't entirely cut out for. He didn't have a clue.
Crap. Absolutely, absolutely crap. Never made a penny, in fact, cost me a fortune.
There we go.
We knew very early on he was a grafter. He used to work very, very hard for me, but he was never, ever going to be a fitter. So we tried to make him into a salesman at the other shop, and I think he was as crap at selling as he was at fitting, so it's a good job he went into boxing.
He suffered worse cuts laying carpet than he ever did laying out his opponents.
I got a phone call from a lady customer turning round and saying to me, can you come out here? I've got a young fitter outside. He's cut all his fingers. I went round. He sat on the wall outside somebody's house. His hands up there. The lady put a plaster on every finger. And it was then we thought, no way. He's never going to be a carpet fitter.
Matthew Hatton is 3 years younger than big brother Ricky. He's training for his own fight that's on the same night as Ricky's Manchester homecoming bout.
I'll be challenging for the Commonwealth title. This is my first major title fight. A fight I'm very confident of winning. And hopefully if I can pick up this Commonwealth title, that's going to be my springboard to go on to bigger and better things and hopefully one day leading to a world title fight.
Matthew has decided to follow in his brother's footsteps.
I suppose seeing how well Ricky, was doing was part of the reason why I fancied taking up again, but there was just something within myself where I fancied doing it.
There's rivalry between the two brothers that started when Matthew, aged 6, and Ricky, aged 9, faced each other in a kickboxing bout.
I knocked 10 bells out of him and and that's history.
But Matthew has nothing but admiration for Ricky, and the brothers do get on.
I'm Ricky's number one fan. I'm so proud of what he's achieved. As far as brothers go, you couldn't get much closer, really.
Matthew lives with his girlfriend Jenna and 5-week-old baby Jack, just minutes away from the rest of his family.
I can walk to Ricky's house in 2 minutes. Walk to my mum's house in 3 minutes. We live so close.
The evening ritual for both brothers is to go for a 5-mile run. but the two boxers have different priorities.
And have my tea ready for when I get back, or else.
Jenna, do you hear me?
Whilst Matthew sorts out the menu, Ricky sorts out the tunes.
You ease into the run and then you pick it up once you're warmed up, so I'll probably start off with a bit of Frank Sinatra.
Quiet nights of quiet stars, quiet chords from my guitar, floating on the silence that surrounds.
Pick the pace up. Oasis, Stone Roses. Good round here with there being lots of fields, you've got to dodge the arse shit as well.
And as they live so near to each other, they both run the same routes.
Yeah, my brother is not just my brother, he's my best mate. We do everything, I get together, from spar together, train together, we run together, we go out for a pint together. You know, he's my best mate.
Don't be shy.
It's not just boxing that runs in the Hatton family, it's carpets.
We do okay.
And Carol keeps herself out of trouble by running her own little sideline.
What size are you, 5x4 or 6x3?
With a 35-year reign, undoubtedly, the undisputed, undefeated champion of the Hatton family is Carol Hatton.
Just come over here. 6.99 per square yard.
Even though her son is a millionaire boxing champion, in the small village of Glossop, you'll find Carol running her carpet stall in a local indoor market, as she's done for the last 6 years.
I'm a customer here. This is my little solitary place, yeah. I like it. But I still can't get away from boxing, because even the teddy bear's got boxing gloves on. I just love coming here 3 days a week. I'm not ready for the Hoover and the Palace yet. No. Mushrooms? No, you want fruit and veg? They're outside, love, weed the carpets.
Her unusual sales style is renowned and Carol's become a bit of a local legend herself. She's got no intention of doing anything else, however successful Ricky becomes.
I mean, don't you think this is much better than retirement? Who wants to bloody retire when you get paid for having a laugh? Not me. He's like a celebrity now. He's always switching on the television and his little flat nose is always on the telly. But to me, myself, it's just Richard. Give him a crack if he needs it.
But whilst Carol's left flogging carpets, it's rather more glamorous work for her boys. At a London casino, they announce Ricky's next opponent, Juan Lascano. It's been one of the fastest-selling events in boxing history. 45,000 tickets sold in the first 6 hours. From boxer to local celebrity and fundraiser, tonight, Ricky's billed as an after-dinner speaker at a charity bash. And anyone who comes to the meal can get a signed photo with all the proceeds going to charity. The event is also supported by Mum Carol, and it's not long before the rest of the family arrive.
Please welcome our guest of honour this evening, Mr. Ricky the Hitman!
Ricky makes his entrance and soon shows he's got more than one knockout punch in his locker.
What a pleasure it is to be standing in front of all you fine people this evening. And, in fact, that's a lie. After the last fight, I'm just happy to be f***ing standing, to be honest with you. But, what an absolute pleasure to entertain an audience without someone trying to smash my f***ing teeth in for the thing. No, but like you say, the fans, they always get great support. And you know, how nice it is for so many people to come up to you and go, hey, Ricky, we went to Vegas last time and saw you, last time out against Floyd Mayweather. What a wonderful time we had. Glad some of you had a f***ing good time.